Guys, no? Itong raided Pogo in Pampanga linked to trafficking other crimes, no? One stop shop pala ito ng mga crimes, no? So, mukhang pati yung judge mukhang nabili yata, no? So, tignan natin. Biglang inano ng ano eh. Pakinggan natin yung interview.
Information that there was something happening there in this humongous facility. How long did it take you to confirm the information that your office had received?
Sagot.
5 weeks. We started receiving information about this particular scam hub. By 5 weeks, I mean we started receiving actionable information 5 weeks ago. But we've been receiving adverse reports about Lucky South 99 about their alleged...
Ayan, ito yung facility San Laki, oh. Pampanga.
Criminal activities inside this compound way back last year. If I'm not mistaken, around November, we've already been receiving reports way back November. But those were not actionable because we weren't able to do a case build-up. But 5 weeks ago, we received reports from different foreign nationals and even Filipinos of the illegal activities happening inside this particular compound. By illegal activities, I'm referring to torture videos. I'm referring to women being sold online.
Yun, kumpleto na ang ano nila, criminal. May currency, may human trafficking, may kidnapping, may prostitution, may lab scam, may troll farm. Meron silang cybercrime na nag-hack sila sa government mga facilities, no? Yung mga hinahack nila yung mga agency natin, ano? Saka pati mga traffic lights, pinag-hack nila, no? Para makita nila kung sino yung mga dumadaan sa mga highway, no?
Sexual exploitation.
No, may mga sexual exploitation pa.
As early, as late as this afternoon, this morning, at 12:30 a.m. This morning, one Chinese national was able to escape, handcuffed to a bed post, handcuffed to a bed frame.
Kinikidnap nila pala yan.
12:30 a.m. this morning and got the attention of the Philippine National Police Special Action Force who is securing the perimeter of this particular scam farm.
Hang on, let's backtrack a bit, Winston.
Scam farm.
Track a bit. Yeah. This Chinese national handcuffed to a bedpost was still in the facility even after the raid happened June 4th. It's that big that you weren't able to get this this person? You weren't able to see him at the time of the raid?
Yes, ma'am. It is what happened. We got a warrant on June 4. Unfortunately, June 5, the same judge
Yon.
Issued the warrant. For whatever reason, unbeknown to us, only known to her, reversed the said search warrant and prevented us from implementing the warrant that we had. So,
kita mo ha? Judge. Ha? Baka, ano ang ibig sabihin niyan, judge? Ha? Diba?
Oh, no!
Diba? Judge.
So we did not enter the facility anymore on yesterday. So we got out of the facility, we just secured the perimeter. Then at 12:30 a.m. the same today, one Chinese national was able to escape, tied handcuffed to a bed frame, and he told us that he was kidnapped from Pasay on
the Yon. Yun, mahalaga to. Yung pala, ginagawa nila, kinakidnap nila dyan sa Pasay, Paranaque, yung mga Chinese. Talagang matinding ang ano na to, kung sindikato na ito, malalakas ang loob gumawa ng criminal activity rito sa bansa natin.
There is a great likelihood that there are still a good number of nationals
marami.
Who may be inside the facility. Because look 59. At the expanse of the facility. It's huge. It's humongous.
Actually, 59 daw yan eh. Or around 60 building yan. Mas malaking hindi hamak yan sa 34 building lang ng Banban Tarlac.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing now in terms of, because the judge reversed the warrant, Are your hands tied with this one now? What do you intend to do?
There's nothing we can do. We have to respect the independence of the judiciary in performing their functions.
Ay, hindi, pwede niya ireklamo yan. Bakit niya reverse niya? Dapat merong kaukulang... dapat inano niya na canon law. Kasi nag-issue na nga siya ng warrant eh. Tapos ano yun, nagkamali siya. Di ba? Dapat mag-explain yung judge doon.
If the same judge reversed the initial search warrant that she gave us, then she is within her mandate to do that. But then again, that doesn't prevent us from applying for another search warrant to be able to yan. Get into the facility and take custody of the facility eventually.
But she's gonna
talagang merong
to issue that same warrant or
oh.
I mean, you're gonna
We applied with a different judge.
Okay.
Ayan, mag-apply ka lang ng different judge. Ganun lang kasimple. Actually, yung NBI may judge na rin yun. Bakit ganun? Wala ba kayong sariling mga judge? Dapat may mga judge din kayong sarili, no? Hindi sa mga ano, dapat may para, 'di ba, integrated na 'yon. Kasi mahirap kung mababayaran yung mga judge, dapat yung mga judge na hindi nababayaran yung sa inyo. 'Di ba? Yun yung mag-evaluate. So, with this development, lumalabas dito na one-stop shop pala itong Pogo, no? Marami palang leads to other crime, no? Iba-iba. Maraming klase ng binanggit ko na kanina. May human trafficking, may mga money laundering, may kidnapping, may prostitution, may mga drug pangang involved dito kasi yung money laundering galing mga ano eh. So, may mga kidnapping sila, human trafficking. Tapos, nagto-torture sila, prostitution, love scam, nang-hack din sila ng mga sites, at kung ano-ano pa, mga troll farm, hindi natin alam kung ano pa nga, basta lahat ng scam, pinasok na nila. One-stop shop ng criminal activity ang Pogo. So, dapat talagang matanggal na rin talaga. So, yun lang po muna at maraming salamat at sana maimbestigan tong judge na ito, no? Bakit siya nag-reverse niya yung decision niya. So, yun lang po muna at maraming salamat sa inyo. Please, like, share and subscribe, no? And thank you for supporting our channel. Marami pa tayong ang susunod natin ay yung huling-huli yung pagsisinungaling ng abogado ni Alice Goo, no? Sinungaling talaga. So, yun ang susunod na natin. Maraming salamat sa inyo lahat. I love you all.